Okay, so I know my last video I uploaded was a back day, but we're going back to back back days, and I'm gonna do a lat focus back day. My last back day was upper back focus, so I really wanna hit the latissimus dorsi pretty fucking hard. Actually, really fucking hard, because that's the only way I'm gonna put on more contractile tissue, is give the muscle a new stimulus it's never felt before. So that's the plan, that's the goal. That is what's gonna occur in this workout. I'm gonna completely torture these lats. Like, I just want them to be fucking in. I just want them to be in a lot of pain during this workout. Because to me, when a muscle is like hurting, when it's burning, when it's like under a lot of tension, then it has to grow. It has no other option. Like, you're giving it no other option but to grow when it's under that much tension, under that much stress. Muscle growth is actually very simple. You just got to give the muscle a reason to adapt to get bigger and stronger. So yeah, just don't overcomplicate it, guys. Don't overthink your workouts, because that's just not going to lead to the most amount of growth when you're overthinking every set. Just, you know, give the muscle the necessary stimulus to grow. You know how hard you need to train to grow muscle. Like, if you're training and you're like, fuck, I could have went harder, then, I mean, that's on you, bro. That's literally on you. You should have fucking did that extra rep. You should have done those extra partial reps. You should have done an intensifier. You should have done a drop set. You should have done a rest pause set. Yeah, have some fucking self-respect, bro. Train hard. Respect yourself. If you don't respect yourself, you're not going to train as hard. So the harder you train, the more you're going to respect yourself. So it's actually like a really good outcome to train hard, because you just gain more self-respect. And that's very important. Just not even outside the gym. Like, when you have a fucking insanely hard training session, your self-respect, your confidence outside the gym grows. So honestly, that's the answer to all your fucking problems, is training hard. So please just start training with maximum intensity and effort. That's all I want you to do. That's all I'm trying to get across with these videos, is for you, for you, the viewer watching, to train harder. Because I want you to achieve the physique of your dreams. I want you to achieve your maximal potential. And the only way you're going to do that is by training fucking hard. Yo, pause. Honestly, I could not be more excited for this back day, because it's just like, it's just like a different type of connection. I've always connected super well with my lats, so this is just going to be a really good experience for me. I'm so grateful for the fucking gym every time I'm here. Like, I'm just so glad that I'm able to train, because think about it, guys. There's some people out there who don't even have the ability to fucking train. So in all fucking honesty, you need to really appreciate your ability to train, because you never know when it's going to go. You could fucking die tomorrow, bro. And then if you didn't train hard, you're gonna really not gonna be fucking happy. You're like, fuck, my last training session, I trained like a bitch. Oh my God, that would fucking suck. So that's not gonna be me. And I'm gonna train my back with maximum intensity and effort. I'm two meals deep. I had some protein oats in the morning with blueberries and peanut butter. And then I had turkey, rice, and honey for my pre-workout meal. And I'm probably going to buy some, like, an energy drink for pre-workout in the fucking gym. And we're going to be fucking solid. So I'm going to go in and warm up, get everything feeling good, get everything fucking flowing. And I just want you guys to enjoy this fucking workout, because I sure as hell am. Oh.
motivation may imply a lot of things to a lot of people. To me, motivation is hating to leave the gym. I mean, I hate to leave the gym and know inside me that I could have gave a little more. I hate to know that I gave up. I hate it so bad I'll never do it. I don't care if I'm sick and thrown up in the gym. I'll keep going so I can leave the gym and go, I did it.
There's no secret. Secret lies within you. So I can tell people how I train, I can tell them what I eat and all these things. That's the boring part, you know? Anybody can train and eat, but what's driving you to do what you do in life? This is the most important thing. What drives you? Because what drives you will be an influence to someone else.
You'll never know how good you might have become unless you try. In order to train as hard as possible, you must retain a clear image of your purpose.
What's your purpose?
You know, whatever it takes. I don't know. I'm not conscious about it. I'm pushing myself to the limit. And if you're doing that, you're probably going to make some noise. Yeah, you brutalize yourself for a very short period of time, and then you let your body recover and overcompensate and grow, and that's the process.
You don't enter this gym unless you're here to train.
But you got to be a little mental, I think, to do what I did. I don't want to, like, sound crazy, but you have to be a little fucked up.
The fucking mindset of, like, getting up every day and pushing yourself.
So I would do things to distinguish myself from the pack. I wouldn't be in the gym training when everybody else was there. As a matter of fact, I would disappear the last month. Nobody knew where I was. I would never show up in a public place. And I was always under wraps.
Do you know your purpose? What you're created to do? Do you know what that is? A lot of people live their entire lives not knowing. Entire lifetime.
Okay, that's a wrap on the workout. Had a fucking blast that back day. Like, I don't know what it is about back day. It just gets me in a certain type of mood, and I just feel fucking like I'm on top of the fucking earth type of shit. So, yeah, just super grateful to be able to experience another back day. Ain't taking that shit for granted, because eventually I'll be no longer able to train, and that's going to be a sad day. But we're getting in these good-ass training sessions. We're making progress. We're getting closer to the goal, and that's all I can ask for. So, yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed that workout. Now I got to feed the muscle with another meal. I'm going to eat my third meal, just turkey and rice again with a little bit of honey. And I'm going to fucking enjoy that meal. You best believe I'm going to enjoy that meal. I'm going to take a rest day tomorrow. Body needs it. I pretty much train 3 days on, 1 day off. I try to. Sometimes I'm too addicted to training and I just train like 6 days in a row, and you know, that might not be the most anabolic way to train, but for the mental side, I love training, so it's helping my mental health. Maybe not my physical health, maybe I'm not optimizing the fucking most amount of muscle doing that, but I'm having a good time and that's what counts. So yeah, that back pump was fucking crazy. Like when I when I took the fucking pump cover off and was like doing back poses, I was like, holy shit, I've never felt this before. So that was really good. I didn't film like every single set. I tried to just film the most important sets. Sometimes when I'm trying to set up a camera, it just takes away from my focus. So I just lock in and then don't film a set. I'm gonna start prep soon. So I really want to document the prep because it's something I'm gonna want to look back on, because I just love bodybuilding. So the more videos I can make, the more I can look back on this experience and be like, yo, this shit was hella dope. Yeah, right now I can't really think about anything else except my post-workout meal. So I don't got much else to say. Yeah, this is gonna be the end of the video. It's gonna be. I just love you guys, so peace out. Have a great rest of your day.